Hi everybody, my name is Tim Borland with timborland.com here on behalf of the stick. I want to take a brief moment just to demonstrate how this is used and also really to focus on the calf area and pain and injury that can come from these trigger points that we talk about or the buildup of myofascia in your calf. First thing is to get yourself in a comfortable position where your muscle also is very relaxed. You want to make sure that you can dig in real deep, and you definitely don't want anything to be tight. So get things relaxed. Sitting down is usually a good position. The next thing to do is to think about how you hold the stick. You want as much force as you can up into your muscle to get the deep, deep trigger points. So to do that, make sure you keep your palms facing up so you can pull up on the stick and really dig in with a lot of force. There's a lot going on in the calf. Things from your Achilles tendon hurting to pain behind the knee, to plantar fasciitis, to your big toe, to ankles, just to calf cramps. There's so much going on in the calf that, again, what we want to do is we want to find those trigger points, those hot spots, and we want to get in and really start digging in on those. You might want to start off just by rolling up and down all the way, you know, from ankle to knee. And when you find one of those spots that really hurts, you want to dig in on that. You want to do just some quick strokes, 15 to 20 strokes, no more than about 30 seconds, and then you want to let go and relax and not worry about that area. It might be a tingling sensation, but that's what happens, is the blood is coming back into that dead area, so to speak. So remember the Achilles tendon. If you've got a real tight Achilles tendon, you know, Achilles tendonitis, oftentimes really what's going on is you've got one of these trigger points, you know, just above your Achilles tendon. So get in with the stick, really start digging in there, trying to figure out, you know, find where that hot spot is, and spend some time on that. You do this about 5 times a day, again, just for 30 seconds. Stay on this for a couple of, you know, several days in a row. You really should start noticing that your Achilles will free up. You know, again, if it's posterior knee pain, you want to stay higher up on the knee, up here, or just below the knee. There's some more trigger points back there that you'll find. If it's plantar fasciitis, again, it's back in your calf, you're gonna find some trigger points, and that's gonna release the tension in your arch, because again, as there's a knot up in your calf, it's reducing the elasticity of your muscle and thus your tendon, and therefore, as you're asking your calf to give, it's not. So what's happening is the end result is it's pulling on the tendon at the connection point of in the fascia on your arch. So work on that calf up and down, find those trigger points, stay on them, give them a good, you know, 30 seconds, and then move on to the next one.